Welcome back to What She Said. Vuka is a Zulu word that means to awaken and stir into action. Vuka Innovation is dedicated to helping organizations create game-changing ideas and strategies to deliver new value through business design methodology. So here to explain exactly what that means is CEO Heather Fraser. So let's tackle the basics first, Heather. Explain what business design means.
So business design is a practice that essentially combines design thinking, which is a popular notion these days, with strategy and activation within an organization. Design thinking is an approach to problem solving and innovation that has been quite widely adapted these days, that essentially is anchored in understanding people, exploring new ideas, experimenting with those, and moving those ideas forward in an iterative way. It's not totally a new notion, but it is something that has really come to life in the last couple of decades. Business design adds to that another essential element, which is strategy. How do you scale those ideas that you come up with? How do you turn those into an operation and provide the systems and structures within a company to be able to actually see those ideas come to reality? So it's a combination of design thinking and strategy, essentially.
So why is there so much interest in it right now?
Well, as we all know, innovation is the name of the game, and that involves exploring new ideas that are outside your current set of considerations. It's not good enough to be incremental, and it certainly isn't good enough to take 12, 18, 24 months to come up with an idea like the olden days. So companies now need to be quick. They need to be able to open up their thinking to explore new ideas, and that's all part of the innovation process. A lot of companies have found themselves in a situation where they are essentially stuck. They've become quite successful because they've built these great systems and they've scaled them to, in some cases, a global success. It's hard to break out of that, and so design has become a means to do that.
So is that what you mean by when you refer to a phenomenon of design thinking becoming the fast food of innovation?
Yeah, so here's the problem as I see it. In a world where everyone needs to step outside the norm, find new ways of exploring new ideas.
Outside the box, how long have we been hearing
outside
that?
Outside the box. And in that world, there a lot of companies are saying, well, what do we do to get going on this? And this notion of design thinking, which has become quite popular in the last couple of decades, is a good start. It's about focusing on people. It's about making ideas tangible and prototyping them, and about testing them out with, you know, importantly, the people that are going to use them. So that's a good start. The problem is it's not a panacea, and it's not the end in itself. Mm-hmm. What can often happen, and I've heard countless stories of this, is an organization will invest in design thinking. They'll put people through boot camp, and they'll give them a quick playbook, and it's like, here's three things. So suddenly you look around a company, and you see people with sticky notes and listening to stories and prototyping little ideas and working in groups, and it's all fun, but it's not enough. And then it all kind of hits the wall, and the people who have enjoyed that process, that creative and generative process, are energized by it, but then they get disappointed when they don't know where it's all going to land and how it plugs back into the operation. At the same time, there's a lot of skeptics on the side saying that design thinking is all fluff. Now, it's not all fluff. It's actually a deep discipline, but when I call it the fast food of innovation, it's that situation in which a company thinks there's a quick hit, get people going on these three little exercises, and suddenly we all become an innovative company. It doesn't work that way.
So what do you do when you go in to a company? How do you help them decide to invest in developing design-inspired innovation?
Well, there's a number of things you have to do. One is just to start the process, you have to ask yourself, what do you really want to be as an organization, you know, in terms of innovation? What's its role in your business? And I think most CEOs nowadays are saying, well, we have to innovate, period. It's not a stream of activity. It's that we have to move the whole business ahead. So understanding what does that potential picture look like, and what's your ideology as as an organization? Do you embrace design? How are you going to make an inclusive process? So really thinking deeply about what you want that organization to look like. The second thing that we do is we measure it. We start from the beginning and say, all right, you want to be innovative? You want to be design inspired? Let's measure that. So we have an instrument that we use that looks at the whole organization and balances out the factors, including the business, how aligned are you on the strategy and how does it translate in everybody's jobs. We look at the practices. What is it that you do on a daily basis that gives you that agility and that ability to innovate? We look at the systems and structures and processes to understand how are you built now and is that able to absorb new ideas and get them into the marketplace. And then last is the general picture of culture. So we envision what the future would look like. We measure it. And then we go about a process of embedding design thinking into an organization. But importantly, doing that with an eye to where does this fit in the whole organization strategy? Is this going to pop out an idea that needs a whole strategy on its own? Is it going to inform the strategy, the future strategy of the enterprise? And then designing, it really ends with designing the organization to adapt to these ideas. Mm-hmm. And rethinking all of those management systems that can either help or hinder new ideas getting to the market.
But because you can measure it, the company would see that it's working.
You can. What you can measure is you can measure the perception of people are, what are the things that are helping us and what are the things that are getting in our way?
Right.
So, for example, we don't have a process to get experiments into the marketplace. We are not aligned on our strategy. We don't take the time to deeply understand customers. So you're measuring the indicators or the drivers of innovation that, based on all kinds of history and evidence, both from the real world and the academic world, all of these factors are part of companies that have had a long-term track record of innovation and business success.
Now, does the next edition of your book address all of this, all the change?
It does. The first edition was one of the first how-to books, and in business, a business application of design. But I found that all of those things that I've just mentioned were kind of missing. So what this book does is it does a few things. One is it looks at the whole organization to say, you got to think about the enterprise, because at the end of the day, it takes a whole enterprise to deliver big ideas. So how do you engage more people? How do you build your capacity? How do you shift your way of working as an organization? So that's number one. It's more emphasis on that. Number two, there's more emphasis placed on analysis and validation. Some say that design is for people who don't like numbers. That's, of course, not true. You really have to, throughout the process, include data analysis and validation along the way, because ultimately you got to make a business case. So those are two themes that are woven into it.
Is there one company we would all know that you think's doing it really well?
There's many, actually, and there are many, many companies over decades that have been doing this, kind of inherently in just the way they do business in their culture. You take a company, I'm going to give you two companies. Nike, which has been doing it from day one. It was founded by an athlete and a coach, and the coach prototyped the first shoe on a waffle iron. So they've been doing this forever. It's part of their organization. I've worked with them. They're deeply committed to their customer, the athlete, and they're constantly trying new things. Then there's a company, Procter & Gamble, that I also worked for, that is first class in running a global business that is efficient and effective and tight with systems, super disciplined. However, they years ago decided that design had a bigger potential. So they took on business design and design thinking as something as a transformation. And they made it all-inclusive. They committed to it. They did it worldwide. They integrated it with strategy and their operations.
Awesome. Okay, that's Heather Fraser, the founder and CEO of VUCA Innovation. It's VUCA innovation.com if you want to connect with Heather. Thank you so much for coming
in. Thank you.
This is What She Said. We'll be right back.